tilting level. Definition: a surveying instrument with sighting telescope so mounted that it can be raised or lowered through a limited arc without impairing accuracy of reading, though axis of rotation is not precisely horizontal. Theory: in the case of dumpy level, the line of sight is perpendicular to the vertical axis. In the case of tilting level, however, the line of sight can be tilted slightly without tilting the vertical axis. Thus, the line of sight and the vertical axis need not to be exactly perpendicular to each other. This feature therefore helps in quick leveling. The instrument is leveled roughly by the 3-foot screws with respect either to the bubble tube or small circular tube, thus making the vertical axis approximately vertical. While taking the sight to a staff, the line of sight is made exactly horizontal by centering the screw which tilts the telescope with respect to the vertical axis. It is, however, essential that the observer should have the view of the bubble tube while sighting staff. The various components are as follows: leveling screw, micrometer level, cross level, scale, milled head, clamp screw, prism, detector, telescope, and ray shuttle. Precision. Precision is a description of random error, a measure of statistical variability. In simpler terms, given a set of data points from repeated measurements of the same quantity, the set can be said to be accurate if their average is close to the true value of the quantity being measured, while the set can be said to be precise if the values are close to each other. Error. An error may be defined as the difference between the measured value and the actual value. For example, if the two operators use the same device or instrument for finding the errors in measurement, it is not necessary that they may get similar results. Both measurements. The difference that occurs between both the measurements is referred to as an error. Sequentially, to understand the concept of errors in measurement, you should know the two terms that define the error. They are true value and measured value. The true value is impossible to find out the truth of quantity by experimental means. It may be defined as the average value of an infinite number of measured values. Measured value can be defined as the estimate value of true value that can be found by taking several measured values during an experiment.
Come to labeling. Labeling is done by two methods: height of collimation method and rise of fall method. In height of collimation method, the elevation of the plane of collimation for the first step of level is determined by adding back sight to the reduced level of a benchmark. The reduced level of the intermediate point are determined by subtracting successively the intermediate sight and fall sight from the reduced level. The instrument is then shifted to the second position and a new plane of collimation is set up by taking a BS at the change point. By means of back sight and fall sight on the change point, the level of two plane of collimations are interrelated. The elevation of the new plane of collimation is obtained by adding the back sight taken at change point from second position to RL of the first change point. Then the reduced level of successive points and the second change point is obtained by subtracting the staff readings from the elevation of new plane of collimation. In the rise and fall method, this method consists of determining the difference of levels between the consecutive points by comparing their staff readings. The rise and fall is obtained by calculating the difference between the consecutive staff readings. A rise is indicated if the back sight is more than fore sight. Then the reduced level of each point is obtained by adding the rise or subtracting the fall from the reduced level of the preceding point. In both rise and fall method and height of collimation method, the calculation is checked by the following condition. If the difference between summation of fore sight and back sight is equal to last RL and first RL's difference, then the calculation is true or correct. Here in the problem, 10 readings are there, in which the after 4th and 7th readings the change point are there. So accordingly, the first reading is at back sight and the last reading is fore sight, and the 4th and 7th reading as they are the change point are taken at the foresight, and immediately after 4th and 7th, the 5th and 8th reading are at backsight. Then accordingly the calculation is done. The summation of foresight and the summation of backside differ by 0.78, and also the last RL and first RL are differ by 0.78. as both the differences are equal, hence our calculation is correct. Similarly, in rise and fall method, the both foreside and backside different, and equal, as this implies that this is correct.
I am going to tell you about reciprocal leveling. This method is adopted to accurately find the difference in elevation between two points which are at a considerable distance apart with intervening obstacle. In this method of leveling, error is very less. Now let us consider two points A and B on the opposite banks of the river. Now the level is set up near to A, and the staff readings of A and B are taken as A1 and B1 respectively. Now the level is shifted to B, and the staff readings of A and B are taken as A2 and B2 respectively. In the first case, as the level is set up near A, the error of staff reading of A is less and considered as A1 itself. Let E is the error of staff reading of B. Correct staff reading of B is equal to B1 minus C. True difference level between A and B, that is H, is equal to A1 minus B1 minus E. Let it be as the first equation. Similarly, in the second case, true difference level between A and B, that is H, is equal to A2 minus E minus B2. Let it be as the second equation. From equations 1 and 2, we'll get H is equal to A1 minus B1 plus A2 minus B2 by 2, that is the average of differences observed from the opposite banks of the river. Now coming to the example, in this example they have given that staff readings at A and B when the setup is near to A were 2.286 and 3.396 respectively. When the level was set up near B, the staff readings at A and B were 3.069 and 1.989 respectively. Now we need to find the true difference of level between A and B. Apparent difference of level between A and B, that is H, is equal to 3.396 minus 2.286, that is equal to 1.11, fall from A to B, that is equal to A1 minus B1. Now the apparent difference of level between B and A, that is H, is equal to 3.069 minus 1.989, that is equal to 1.08 meters, that is equal to A2 minus B2. Now the true difference, that is equal to A1 minus B1 plus A2 minus B2 whole divided by 2, is equal to 1.095 meters. Thank you.
Plane, refraction and curvature correction. Earth has a curved face which is assumed to be a level surface, but the line of sight as furnished by the leveling instrument is horizontal and not the level of line. Therefore, all points on the line of sight are not equidistant from the surface of Earth, and consequently the points read on the staff are not strictly at the same level as horizontal hair of the level line falls away from the horizontal line of sight, and the vertical distance between effect of curvature of Earth. In figure 7.24, A is the instrument station and P is the point where the staff is held. On looking through the telescope, we sight along FB, the horizontal line of sight, and take the staff reading PB. The point B is considered to be at the same level as A, but actually the points C and A are at the same level. The true reading is BC. The difference BC between observed and true staff readings denotes the error due to curvature of Earth, which may be determined as follows. D is the length of sight or distance from the instrument to the staff station in kilometer. BC is the error due to curvature. O is the center of Earth. R is the radius of Earth. C is the curvature correction. Now, if we will apply Pythagoras theorem in triangle ABO, AB square equal to A square plus OB square, AB equal to R plus C, now R square plus 2RC plus C square equal to R square plus T square,
R square, R square get cancelled. Then 2RC equal to D square. C equal to D square by 2R. So if we'll calculate, then we will get C equal to 0.0785 times D square, which is negative. Now we'll come to refraction correction. Light passing through layers of different densities do not remain straight but are refracted or bent down towards the denser medium. The earth's surface, as the density of air decreases as height increases. Radius of this refracted curve is 7 times earth's surface, which is positive. Now combined correction, curvature correction and refraction correction. D equal to 7. So the total CD comes 0.067 times D square.